Jumping in these nuts.
Da-da-da-da-da. You're listening to the Name of That podcast with Alton and Eddie.
And Danny.
Hey, I'm still in jail, though.
Eddie's still in prison, guys. He exposed himself outside, is what the narrative is. But don't let the fake news media deter you in your quest for knowledge and finding the facts.
Y'all better make his commissary look pretty.
Yeah. Yeah, so you can make Eddie's commissary look real pretty by donating to our Patreon that does not exist. But if you'd like the Patreon to exist, donate on Patreon.
Ted Cruz is quarantined with me in here right now, actually.
Yeah, I heard Ted Cruz had to quarantine himself because he came into contact with a coronavirus patient.
Yeah, he's right here.
Hey, Ted, you on the line?
Hello?
No.
Hey, Ted Cruz, you're in prison with our friend Eddie?
Oh, I don't know this guy. I just look like a vampire.
Oh, that's fair. Odd Nosferatu, or should
I? Have they let him have his porn-a-rooney while he's in there?
Do you get the porn while you're in there, Ted?
I get out of here, bitch. I stole his app. He had a little tablet, so like it was like nannies for grannies.
Gotcha. The name of that podcast is brought to you by Nannies for Grannies.
Yeah.
What does that even mean?
Hold my arm while I walk down the stairs.
Aw, how wholesome.
The name of that podcast is also brought to you by Ted Cruz Missiles.
Oh, that's a good one.
They may not be that big, but they sure got a bang.
Honestly, Ted Cruz Missiles could really use the money. I heard beavers got into their hutch and ate half of their brood.
He laid a fucking egg in his bed last night.
Well, that's his business, Eddie. It's 2020.
Oh, they weren't beaver, they were platypus?
Right.
Yeah. But hey, you're listening to the name of that podcast, and what I imagine is March, smack dab in the middle of Women's History Month. Woo woo!
Woo!
Yeah. Let me tell you.
Bitches be doing shit.
Hell yeah, bitches be doing shit all day. Is it okay for me to say that?
Month too, huh?
Yeah, whatever. I don't care.
So like it's Bitches History Month. I just got permission from my friend Danny to say that.
He got his bitch card, y'all.
I did. I got it. It's my B card. I can say it now.
Didn't you have to do like a whole essay on the word bitch? Aren't you the most qualified person in the world to say the word bitch?
You just reminded me of that. So when I was 12 years old, I was like 10 years old.
Oh my god!
I had called my younger sister a bitch.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. My mom was none too happy. She did not stand for people calling women bitches. She's very anti-calling women bitch. So she gave me an ultimatum. She's like, son, I'll either beat your ass right now, right here, right now, in front of your family members, or you could write a 500-word essay about why you shouldn't say the word bitch. And I was just like, you know what?
You want to beat your ass, right?
So here's the thing. What she said was, for every day it is not finished, I will add 500 words to the essay.
Yo, just beat my ass then.
So,
get over with.
So
you don't know him.
This was the first time I was given an ultimatum of this measure. I chose the essay. Long story short, it took me 3 days to complete, so I wrote a 1,500-word essay on the word bitch and why you shouldn't call people bitch. Turns out there's not a lot of reasons not to call someone a bitch.
So it was a lot of double spacing. And
no, I had to write it. We didn't have a computer. I had to write it.
Oh my god.
Yeah. We were the poor family.
You can double space handwriter?
Nah, my mom wasn't going to stand for that shit. She ain't stupid. She's not one of those white moms.
Did you make the font?
No, okay, I was just about to say it's dead ass cute that your mom actually gave you the option of writing an S. My mom would have just whooped the shit out of me and made me write the S.
So, like, normally my mom would have, but she was going through something of a crucible. It was character development, you know?
Oh, she was playing Destiny?
Nah, she was playing Let's Make a Deal.
Yeah,
that's So, I ended up writing this 1,500-word essay about the word bitch, where it come from, why people use it on people, and why you, quote, shouldn't. Most of that part was, like, why people do. So, like, a lot of that was, while it's not okay to call someone a bitch,
really
acting like a bitch isn't very good either.
I really hope she still has that essay somewhere.
Here's the worst part. The real punishment? She threw it away. I was like, done with the essay, Mom. And she was like, huh.
That bitch. No, I'm kidding.
So that means I can now?
Yeah, I don't know. So I got my BHD. I wrote my bitchertation.
Your pedigree.
So I can say it. Happy Women's History Month. But,
That's all you need to do.
Yeah. So, Women's History Month, I really like it a lot.
for all the friendly reminders for all the incels, I believe Men's History Month is either October or November, so don't start saying when do we get ours. Yours is later in the year.
Yeah, shut up, incels. Get a life.
Get a life, incels.
Yeah. Why don't you go touch yourself?
I'm just saying, maybe if you can make your personality more adaptable,
yeah,
you can get some pussy.
Let's put them all in a cage and make them fight it out. Winner gets laid.
Yeah.
Ooh, I love it.
We'll call it Hell in the Incel.
Yep.
Hell yeah, it's gonna be great. But hey, how would you guys...
Does someone get thrown off the steel cage?
Oh, it'll definitely happen. They'll get thrown off the steel cage into, like, disembodied vaginas.
Yeah, but, like, can it be incel
vaginas? A
pile of fedoras!
The worst part is they're never fedoras, they're trilbies.
Yeah, well, actually, sir, it's a trilby. Fedoras are for Indiana Jones, and Indiana Jones actually gets laid, so...
Like, all the time.
Outside of the cell is called the friend zone.
Yeah, exactly. If you get thrown into the friend zone, you're eliminated.
Yeah.
So I saw this meme the other day, and I'm going to call it a meme, but because to call it a graphic image is just kind of stupid.
Nerdy.
I don't care about being nerdy. I care about being smart.
I'd shove you in a locker, but I don't know where to find one big enough.
So this picture said there's a difference between unrequited love and the friend zone. And I'm like, yeah, the person who's talking about it.
Literally.
And it's just like, oh, like, yeah, I like them. They don't like me back. That's like, that's fine. But then it's like, they don't like me. Therefore, that is their problem to fix for me. That's different.
They don't like me back even when they're sleeping.
Just enjoy people's company, motherfucker.
Hello. Anyway, in other news, in teaching adult men, I imagine, about how to be a human being.
Because that's a course we really need in these colleges.
Yeah, honestly, we need to teach men how to be humans. Fuck teaching boys how to be men. Teach men how to be people.
Exactly. Oh my god, Glendon has
boys to men.
Yeah, exactly. Boys to men, like the band and the stand. Yo, homie.
We
so,
just hit him with that.
So I was at the Pavone's on Butternut. Eat at Pavone's, young man. Eat at Pavone's, young man's pizzeria. Eat
young
at Pavone's.
Man.
Young man, would you like a pizza?
If you hit the one on Butternut, there will be this nice man trying to harass you into buying movies.
So, as opposed to the Pavone's downtown, where there's a nice man indoors harassing you to buy pizza, the Pavone's on Butternut has a guy outside of it harassing you very nicely to buy illicit DVDs.
Nah, homie looked at me one day. Every time I go down there, he tries to get me to buy movies, and I'm like, nah, man, I ain't got money for that.
That's a real big motherfucker, right?
Yeah.
Yo, this motherfucker looks like, he looks like somebody stuffed the entire cast of Boys in the Hood into a trash bag. They died in the trash bag, but it sprung new life.
He's really just 6 12-year-olds in a trench coat.
Yeah. He's like, y'all want to see a dead body, and he just opens his body.
Yo, how fucked would it be if this finally got an audience and, like, reached him?
And he killed me.
Are you sure he's not just like an enchanted red box that came to life?
they put the enchanted beanie on him and he came to life like Frosty the Snowman.
Yeah, he came to life like Frosty.
Yo, I've never seen him without that beanie either.
Reggie the red box.
Got enchanted heroin needle.
Smoking drugs, motherfucker. You can't do that while I'm inhaling.
Hold on a second. I forgot what I was going to talk about. Oh, so I'm at Pavone's earlier, homie. And we're sitting there. We're eating our pizza. Yeah. Thanks for the pizza, Danny.
You good?
I just want to say real quick. I want to live in a world where I can get pizza from a friend. And it's not Women's History Month.
What does that even mean?
Yeah, I don't get it.
I'm going to quote Susan Huckabee Sanders and say...
Don't ever quote anybody.
The president speaks for themselves. What? Anyway, so I'm inside of the Pavone's. Eat at Pavone's. And there are these two brothers. One's behind the counter. One's talking to him. And they are carrying on, dude, for like 10 minutes about JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
Yo,
and
anime in the hood is real. What?
Anime in the hood is what's up. I was so fucking happy. I'm like, I'm moving in this neighborhood. Literally up the street from that pizza shop. In 3 weeks, I'm like, I found a friend.
I'm so excited.
I'm like, I found my first hood friend. I didn't even have these in my childhood.
Bro, all I'm saying is, like, Japan needs to thank the American ghetto for all the export and import of their media, because, bro, I don't know nobody who fucks with anime like somebody who went to an inner-city school. That's all I'm saying.
Listen, man, I know it's Women's History Month, but niggas love anime.
Bro, girls love anime, too!
Women!
You met these hood bitches! bitches, all of them putting on them fine ass like cosplay of anime. These DBZ characters and
listen,
shit.
Listen, if you a hug girl, you listen to this podcast right now, go watch Michiko and Hachin.
Oh, is that the one I've been meaning to watch? The girl in the...
It's two black girls.
Yeah, and the one's
going
got a kid.
On misadventures. One's got a kid. There, she's looking for her lover and her baby
daddy.
Okay,
yeah.
Yeah. And what's great about the story is the damsel in distress is her husband, who's like this blonde hair, blue eyed, like...
Ooh, I didn't know that part.
Yeah, hipster looking motherfucker. Ooh. And she's out on a crusade to go find him because she loves him. So, like, a lot of people try to, like...
Make He's the Princess show... Peach, motherfucker.
Exactly. So, a lot of people try to make the show like, oh, look at this woman thinking she's got to go find her man to complete her family. No, it's like, no. She wants to do this. Like,
yeah,
she
this
feels
is her...
compelled, Ooh! Not by guilt, not by the patriarchy, but by her
love.
Yeah.
Love, motherfucker. Wholesome.
Wholesome.
We need more wholesome content. I love wholesome content.
Hell
like,
yeah.
Like, don't get me wrong. This edgy shit is great. It's amazing. But we're oversaturating the edgy. We need more wholesome in our lives.
Danny, you should watch Food Wars.
Stop with the food. There's nothing wholesome about Food Wars, bro.
Have you not eaten food before?
Yeah.
That entire show is just umami. Like.
Nah, it's umami, not umami.
It is umami. You see them niggas symbolically nutting all over the place.
That ain't symbolic, bro. Okay, so, have you ever seen Getting the Robot? I showed you that pretty motherfucker Kurt Ritchie doing the anime you shouldn't watch in public.
I'll answer that question with another question. Eddie, do you watch Food Wars?
A little bit, I have.
It's good, right? Like, I don't watch it alone. I have somebody to watch it with, so it's not weird.
Sorry for anybody who's listening to this with headphones and has to hear me.
No, my cousin's the one that watches. But
I like the part where she eats the food and she nuts.
You just like seeing women nut.
I mean, I'm a human being. Lots of humans like seeing humans nut.
We got whole industries.
Yeah, hell yeah. Do you guys want to play Women's History Month trivia?
Sure. Are we playing a game or are you just telling us stuff? Like, are we doing multiple choice answers?
Do you know who Mama Jones is?
Refresh, because it sounds familiar.
She was a labor rights activist back during post-Civil War times.
Okay.
So she fought specifically for like fair working conditions and like children out of working conditions and shit like that.
Now, Mama Jones, black woman?
No. Why? What made you think that?
Usually, when somebody has the title Mama.
Huh?
Usually, when someone has the title Mama.
Oh, you guys heard it here first.
Fair.
I don't know. I'm just
from Danny.
I was about to lead that into a point about how we need to respect women of color, specifically black women, more, who fought for all our rights and blah, blah, blah.
Right, but history will forget them in April.
Probably. We did February, we did March, we did both of them, whatever.
Yeah, I don't even remember who invented peanut butter anymore.
Stop it.
Well, because, like, here's the thing. George Washington Carver didn't. Was my main takeaway from,
like,
Black History
yeah,
Month. But I now I really don't know who invented peanut butter, and it's... And I don't want to look it
peanut.
Up. Mr. Peanut.
Mr. Peanut! Yo, Mr. Yeah. Peanut just did the Phoenix Rebirth.
Centuries of Baby Nut.
Stop. Don't say that.
What do you mean? That's his name.
Please tell me that's not the name they announced him with.
Baby Nut at the Super Bowl. Why would they even want to put that... See, like, I swear to God, NAMBLA must have paid for this fucking...
Please stop.
I'm telling you, NAMBLA must have paid for that ad stuff. They crossed over all the other commercials. You can cough over there.
Sorry.
The name of that podcast is brought to you by Ear Splitting Coughing. Ear Splitting Coughing is what you get when you cough into a microphone.
Sorry, I didn't realize I was aiming directly at the microphone.
That's right. You got to pass. We actually had a name of that cough cast once before coronavirus.
Oh, yeah.
Please stop.
Yeah. Yeah. Also, don't cough on the microphone.
I didn't mean to. I'm sorry.
Well, we can no takesies, backsies. I just don't think you have coronavirus, is all.
Good.
Yeah.
I might Ted Cruz.
Have you been quarantining with Ted Cruz?
Yeah, he falls asleep a lot, but he lays eggs.
Does he like secrete bodily fluids?
Has he talked in his sleep about being the Zodiac killer yet?
He kind of gurgles.
I think
like
he
a drowning noise, but still breathing.
He's like he's submerged in a.
Yeah, it's like you got your gills full.
Yeah. Okay. I understand
you know
now.
That point.
He's kind of like he's kind of like Abe Sapien.
No.
Something like I think he's cold blooded.
I swear to God.
Does he use a lot of blankets?
They hit us with the Shape of Water, and all I could think about was...
Oh, what's this? There's something coming out of the ground. Master! Have you seen the monster?
What the fuck?
Oh, my God. No, little fish man.
Ask him a riddle. Ask him a riddle. Right.
Ask him a riddle.
You might get a ring.
Left a ring for me, though.
Oh, that's lit.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd hold on to that. Jewelry is in high demand in prison, I hear.
You're going to want to put it in the pocket, though.
But hey, speaking of prison, let's talk about female serial killers. Because something that I love talking about are real-life horror movies. And the real-life horror movies are serial killers. So let's go ahead and click on the first one that we find. Janie, you want to go ahead and look up serial killers women? Thanks, Janie.
I bet I know who will come up.
All right, let's go to the list, sponsored by Wikipedia.
Wikipedia, please donate. They need money.
Ooh, okay, so the first one that caught my eye is the Kelly family. I've never heard of these people before.
Oh.
They were born in Pennsylvania, and they all apparently died in 1887. They were killed by a group of Batmen.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Vigilantes are what they're called. That's the race. That's their
Batman?
Yeah, Batman. But they're Batman their species is vigilante.
Vigilante is bad.
Okay.
All right. So the Kelly family were a family of serial killers who operated near a Kansas town called Oak City between September and December 1887. 1 second.
Brought to you by Corona.
Yeah, a coronavirus bud. It's great. The family consisted of Will Kelly, 55, his wife Kate, his son Bill, aka Billy, and his daughter Kit.
Okay, that's good.
Like the Harringtons?
The family is believed to have murdered 11 wealthy travelers, akin to the Bloody Benders a decade earlier. All right, so they killed rich people on the road. They
Bloody
them.
Benders.
Okay, but like...
Yeah, we're the Bloody Benders, speaking of... Ooh, two of them are women.
It's like a bad horror movie.
Elvira and Kate Bender. Do you think they all...
Does that have to do with Rodrigo?
I was going to say, do you think they all sound like John DiMaggio?
Yep, I think so.
You think they wanted you to bite their shiny metal asses?
Because, right.
I mean, like, women back then were wearing the cages and whatnot.
Wait,
the hoop skirts.
The hoops.
Yeah,
oh.
So, like, yeah. Bite my shiny metal ass.
Yeah.
Is totally a plausible statement.
All right, everybody, do their best bender right now.
I'm not.
I'll go first.
God.
I'll go first. Shut up, baby, I know.
God damn it, that was going to be mine.
All right.
Did I just go? Or?
Yeah, just go for it, man. We're hopping there.
All right. Bite my shiny metal ass. Not like an old man.
Not bad, 80-year-old Joey Diaz.
Yeah. I'm aging, and my mother's dead on the floor.
So, it's Women's History Month. And I knock
that's
on her
bender.
Door at 7 p.m., a reasonable hour. She lets me in, I ask consent, and I eat a monkey.
I mean, Joe, we all Me Too'd.
Oh,
that's
God.
That's how you learn not to be a Me Too'er.
That's how
I
you...
Me Too'er.
Oh, no. You. Oh, no. No.
Worst part is you can't get mad at me. That's a quote out of his mouth.
What'd you say?
I said the worst part is no one can get mad at me. That's a quote out of his mouth.
Joey Diaz once said, everybody Me Too'd. That's how you learn not to Me Too.
I love him. And I'm pretty sure I understand what he means by that.
I think it's very mutually understood that a lot of people who love Joey Diaz as a comedian want to be a member of his family so very dearly. If not for the, you know, if
like
not for the history.
He's really like an Uncle Joey.
Yeah, he's really Uncle Joe. He's crazy Uncle Joe. But, like, then there's creepy Uncle Joe, like the anti-Joey Diaz.
Badon?
And that's Badon. Yeah, that's the Jean Badon from France.
Stop.
Yeah, Jean Badain.
That's why I think it's okay to, like, rub up on people.
Man, that guy, okay, that guy's a fucking gaff machine.
Bro, homie's got, like, dementia.
So, speaking of dementia and Joe Biden, female serial killers.
Okay.
Probably the definition of power. Clementine Barnabet. Sounds like a bad bitch to me. This is, actually, Cardi B stands for Clementine Barnabet.
Stop
Did you know that?
No, it does not.
Yeah, it does. So
poisoned oranges.
Yeah, so Cardi B was an African-American serial killer, mass murderer, and a cult member. She committed murders in Louisiana and Texas between 1911 and 1912.
I better watch his shit.
And was believed to be accomplices as a part of a violent religious sect. She eventually confessed to police that she was involved in 35 murders.
Yo, look up the bitch from American Horror Story.
Wow.
Which bitch from American Horror Story?
Oh, what the fuck was her name? It was like Delphine something.
Delphine AHS. Delphine Lalaurie.
Yes! Oh my god, that bitch was horrendous. If half of...
It's Kathy Bates!
Yeah, but don't look up American Horror Story version. Look up the real version, because that was a real-life serial killer. Like, okay, she was fucking horrific.
They'll tell us who she's based on in this, right?
Yeah.
She's
based off of Delphine Lalaurie.
Right. So, Kathy Bates, inside of this American Horror Story episode, has one of my favorite scenes in television. One of them. I don't have a number one. Anyway. So she's since a disembodied head. And
as this character.
Yeah, as this character, Delphine Lalaurie. And this character, Queenie, who's a black girl and a witch, doesn't like that this lady's a racist. Because she used to own slaves and do some real creepy shit to her slaves. To
creepy is such a fucking understatement.
It's a real understatement.
Gruesome is an understatement.
So take like, if I can describe her, take like Hannibal Lecter and mix her with Buffalo Bill, and then sprinkle
Frankenstein,
a Minotaur. Anyway, so she put this disembodied racist head in front of the movie Roots and made her watch it for 9 hours.
Wow.
And then she came back and
like Clockwork Orange.
She was too. Quote cured of her racism.
How to train your pet head?
Yeah, how to train your slave head? How to no not slave head? Sorry, oh my god. How to train your
white supremacist
your racist head. That sounds like a really...
Is that where Tom Hanks got the volleyball?
No, but it is, what? However, how it is, however, the movie that Tommy Lahren watched to learn how to suck dick.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
How to Train Your Racist Head.
Bro. That bitch.
You want to know my least favorite thing about Tommy Lahren?
All of it?
No. Yeah, what?
My,
but yeah.
My least favorite thing, and it's not my least favorite thing as much as it is the worst part about, like,
shoot,
her entire situation.
Shoot.
She's very attractive. She does, like, and the way she treats the world and, like, views it, like,
it's so hideous.
God don't like ugly, though.
Right? Like, that's...
Allegedly. That's why I'm agnostic, because I get cliches like that, you know? I get to have that in my lexicon. Have it in the pocket, you know? Because if I was atheist, I'd have to cut all that God shit out of my shit for integrity, you know?
Nah, you're never gonna get Jesus fucking Christ out of my... lexicon.
Atheists be doing the most. They be like,
oh my god, I know it.
They're like, how dare you say God bless me? Fuck off.
Merry that's Christmas,
like
what?
Extreme. That's like SJW atheist.
Yeah, yeah, SJW atheist. It's like, how dare you?
Yeah.
Oh my god, really?
Somebody's really gonna write how dare you on my fucking grave, though.
That's funny. I'll do it in Sharpie.
You fucking, yeah.
Yeah, how dare you?
I'll race you to the grave, motherfucker.
What was I gonna say? Where do you fall on the religious scale, Eddie?
I'm more atheist than anything, because if it's real, then, wow, not yeah, great.
You're like, man, you've really been doing a bang-up job, to say the least.
do you take notes?
Yeah.
Do you take notes? That's like, I got a whole list of complaints. My mom was a complaint to the manager type growing up.
Yeah.
So I definitely have that gene.
So.
And I'm waiting to complain to the ultimate manager.
So, like, I'm ready to be like, hey, God. So, listen, buddy. Great place you got here. But, so we on Earth have figured out this thing called a suggestion box. And I think you should make a suggestion box. If for nothing else, for the people that die and come to heaven. Because I feel like they'll have, you know, the freshest perspective. What do you think? And I think that'll really go a long way in helping us build the God brand.
And then God's going to be like, hell.
It's because...
Then he's like, yeah.
Because I'm here to work for you.
Like, hit the trap door, yeah, Eddie.
Because, like, what I'd like to think is that God is both very old and dumb, but very, like, smart and young at the same time.
What?
Yeah, because he's everything, you know?
So he's Pete Buttigieg?
Yeah, he's Pete Buttigieg. We really fucked up, guys. Wow. Pete Buttigieg was the second coming. Oh, no, 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 no.
I don't want it.
He didn't do a good job of showing it.
Well, that's because...
I don't... Jon Snow, I don't want it.
That's because he, like, did sensory overload on him. He, like, put too many protocols inside of Pete Buttigieg to try to, like, enter his body. Like, make him gay and moderate. And make him, like, a CIA agent. And, like,
it's a CIA agent. Okay, so, like, I told Jeremy the comment that he made about if I had a pill to not be gay, I would take it.
Yeah.
And Jeremy's eyes went so fucking wide. It was like a cartoon. Yeah. And he was like, and I love watching my brother grow as an individual because I've watched him. He's 36.
Yeah.
And so I've watched him grow more in the last, like, I'd say 5-6 years than I had pretty much his whole life. Because there was a lot of trauma there, and he's working through it. He's a good guy now.
So, like, so for the record, or just for clarification, I should say, Jeremy is your brother?
Yes. Sorry.
Okay. No, no, you're fine. I don't... I know who you are. I've heard all this shit before. Like, I'm getting the reruns. You guys are getting the fresh takes. Oh!
It wasn't hard to boot a gauge.
Yeah, it wasn't hard to boot a gauge for me, at least. Hey, guys, this is Danny.
Hi.
Hi, guys. This is Danny. She's been my friend for a while now. For a while. I don't like thinking about time as, like, you know.
A construct.
Not even as a construct. I don't like recalling it because I already have a poor memory. So how long we've been friends doesn't matter. So, yeah, Danny, I want you to tell the audience a little about yourself, which, don't worry, you're only, like, being listened to by, like, 4 people. Concurrently, at most...
I don't know, 5'2", ball of rage, generally.
Hi, Kenny.
Hi, Kenny. Who's Kenny?
Just...
Hi.
Yeah, hey, Danny said hi, Kenny.
But yeah, 5'2", ball of rage, generally feeling some sort of general malice towards something.
I love it. That's a sick dating profile.
General malice.
General malice. That's like on Tinder, that's just like the employment line. I work at General Malice Hospital.
Right, I am your healthcare provider. Watch out.
Yeah, I'm a healthcare aren't we all healthcare providers of sorts, you know?
We all got medical advice that we shouldn't be giving out.
Yeah, we all got medical advice, and we've all got, like, our own tips and tricks. I'm like, oh, no. Like, my thing as a plus-size person is I get a lot of, like, random, like, pimples and, like,
little... Facts.
Yeah.
Like, out of nowhere.
Just in the most random places. And I'm like, the pimples on my butt cheeks are so sensitive.
Oh, my God.
But I know how to, like, quell those shit so they don't get out of hand, you know? Plus size people,
I'm
you
giving
hear
you
me?
The eyeball emoji right
you know
now.
What I'm talking about, you know? Like, I get them on my butt cheeks, though, because I sit on my ass a lot at work.
Facts.
That's why I try to leave my desk as much as I can.
Yeah, I heard this thing that you're supposed to stand up, like, 10 minutes out of every hour.
Yeah, you know, and they don't mind me standing up. Or maybe they
just
do.
Just make sure you sort the cards while you do it, bitch.
Or no, yeah, just got to make sure my card sorting numbers are, like, up top, you know? Give me the high five on your card sorting numbers. Don't give me a low five.
Well, you better give him a fist bump.
They're like, Alton, step into my office. Thank you for standing in this room with a ladder in it.
There's a ladder.
Your standing metrics are amazing.
I'm honestly blown away by how much you've been able to find time to stand at work. Can you do a classroom when I'm standing?
I feel like there's a whole thing that, like, your job either wants you to sit the fuck down or stand the fuck up. Don't do the either one, or I swear to fucking God, Mary.
Yeah, do both. But pick one.
Nah, there's no... Yeah. Like, what?
Nah, like, you could do...
Not at once.
Yeah. So, like, so a couple of days ago, I had missed the bus. Right? But I didn't miss the bus because, oh no, I'm just terrible with my time. I was standing at the bus stop for about 10 minutes. But, something to note, is that 20 minutes before I had done that, I was just getting out of work, and I spent the last hour and a half of the shift, Eddie... Not talking to anyone, headphones on, filing as hard as I could, right? Doing the damn thing, right? Exactly what they'd like to see. I felt my soul crushed. My soul was crushed. Because, like, because now I'm, like, very in touch with my emotions, and I don't
emotional
normally...
Growth.
Yeah, emotional growth, Brody.
It's 2020, know yourself.
Yeah, so that, and what was I saying? I lost my train of thought because I got validated.
You were in your zone at work.
Yeah, I was in my zone at work. I felt the soul crush, and, like, it felt different because I normally don't do that. You know, I'm normally like, hey, I'll talk and, like, let my numbers slip a little bit. But, you know, I need my numbers to look good right now. But, like, I literally just was in the worst mood for no reason. Like, last hour and a half sucked. And, like, I missed the bus because I dissociated and I couldn't, like, make out the letters and numbers on the bus to tell me it's mine. Like, I could clearly see it. And I remember seeing it, but my brain wasn't registering that was my bus, which was really creepy. Like, that sounds like some old Conjuring Universe shit.
No, when you
said like,
me the
what cabinet does this bus go in?
Yeah, what cabinet is it? I think my bus is cabinet 48. Which doesn't exist yet.
No, when you sent me that message, I was laughing because I could relate. I've done that before. I swear to God.
All right, so the bus I'll be taking when I move, which is great news, everybody. I secured my the money that I need for my lease, and I'll be paying that Saturday, and I'll be moving in April.
So
the name of that podcast is going to be coming to you live from the hood.
Ow. I can't wait for the gunshots.
Hell yeah. Oh my gosh, that's going to be
You're
such a great
You're on Lodi,
episode.
Dude.
I know, I'm on Lodi. Shh, shh, shh.
Cut it out.
It's a long street. I'm not cutting shit out. I stand by my work. What's it, so that'll be fun. I love the hood. You want to know why I like the hood more than I like the suburbs?
Why?
Because there's less crime.
I love it.
Yeah. From the cops. Now you let me finish.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, the cops are committing less crimes in the hood. Kind of. Let me explain. I don't do anything.
He'd just be chilling, yeah.
And mad people in the hood don't be doing anything. Right? It's just when niggas do something, you know, the few that do something when they do something, it just be some old crazy shit. Like,
yo. Okay, so...
So the cops have to solve those crimes, right? And, they don't have time to pull people over and just, like, mess with them and be like, let me see your license. And then just, like, flip it around in their fingers while they, like, check their Twitter. Yeah, they don't do that in the hood because they have to actually work. There's, like, always something to do. No. Always a fire to put out in the hood.
Okay, so
and I'm just
going to
be
laughing
up in my house watching cartoons.
Because I was at work and somebody came in talking about how some dude was just walking down the street
on
Butternut. They said it was near the Rite Aid. Uh-huh. And so I was like, oh, Lord, was it Butternut and Lodi? And they were like, yeah. And I'm like, you know me. It's always.
Hi,
Daddy. Hi. But yeah, it's always Butternut and fucking Lodi, y'all. Yeah. I swear to God, anytime you hear some fucking nonsense, choose your fighter, Butternut and fucking Lodi.
Dude, choose your fighter. So I saw this picture on Facebook, and it was this guy literally sucking his own dick and or eating his own ass on, you guessed it, Butternut
and
Lodi.
Lodi.
I knew it was because the Jurek subs that's on Butternut and Lodi was
Is
right in
the
background.
Picture,
I
so
grew up in those
church.
Streets, man.
Bro. That used to be my Facebook cover
picture. I know these roads. We built these roads.
That used to be my Facebook cover picture.
You ain't shit for that. You really
no,
ain't shit for that.
You know why it was perfect? Because like I said, my avatar would cover the cover picture part where he is, so it just looks like it's that corner.
Go wild a little bit.
Oh, no.
Oh, man. I know they were at Beer Garden and it's trivia night, and Beer Garden serves in pints and liters.
Hello.
The triumphant entrance.
Have a gallon of milk.
No, it's a quart.
It's a half gallon. I'm sorry.
Oh, half gallon.
I'm drunk and I need more beer because Tyler hasn't been feeding
Hello.
Me for the past half an hour.
Hello.
Y'all.
Hey, guys, it's Tyler on the name of that podcast.
On the name of the hashtag Team Tyler.
PBR for you.
Merch.
I got a PBR cozy.
Yeah, nice, right?
Do you want one?
Yeah, please. Hey, guys, we're going to drink some beer here. And we're going to...
Hashtag Team Tyler. Merch available soon.
I have
Stella?
Ideas.
You hear that, man? He's building a brand.
I miss those. I love those.
Kenny, Sarah, help.
Hashtag, here we go.
Make
Women's
merch.
History Month. We
help.
Have two
Stella's.
Now.
Yeah, Women's History Month is brought to you by Stella Artois. Ooh, you dirty
I Trump
rat.
Emoji that.
I Trump emoji that. Holy shit. The room. I felt
you
the room shaking. It was so intense.
Like,
hey, if you're listening to the name of that podcast in the morning, I'll let you know that this is not the time that we're talking.
Nope.
This wasn't one of those, oh, let me wake up in the morning here and scratch my ass and roll some blunts and record the name of that podcast. No, it wasn't one of those. It was those, hey, let me spend my entire day doing nothing. No, I was pretty productive.
My ass bitches, I'm doing nothing about it.
That's right. I'm just going to be
yes,
a
queen.
Burning bitch. A
Yo,
burning
Cass is
itch.
Spitting that real shit.
Alton! I love Danny. He gave me a hug. I love Danny.
Oh, you're welcome?
Danny, you're in my chair.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
You're good.
But this is my specific chair.
That's
I own
right.
this chair.
The name of that podcast is brought to you by I Don't See Your Name on It.
Right?
So Cass is...
it. It's fine.
So Alton, Cass is very mad at Patty.
Why?
Because apparently Patty was coming out of me.
Oh, we're spilling tea, guys. The name of that podcast is Spilling Hot Tea.
So
juice.
I'm sitting there, right? And, like, I'll admit, like, yes, the one thing that did strike me as odd. Ew, I never... Danny, I don't want to see your ass, man.
Jesus Christ.
ever
Tyler,
again.
Tyler!
You literally just showed me your full ass.
I did not, and I'm sorry but, for what you did see.
So, like, Patty was, like, really, like thigh to thigh.
Tyler,
I mean,
this is our recording.
Close. I don't care.
Hot mics.
I'm going like, to grab so weed
she was,
real
like,
quick.
She was, like, right. She was, like, completely close. Right, but like I don't think she was like coming out of me or anything. She was drinking though pretty heavily, and then like we're like walking with Dakota and Danny or yeah Danny's right here.
Hey Tyler.
Dakota and Patty, and Cass is just like sort of going off next to them to me, and I'm like
she's so drunk she can't even hear.
Need you just stop.
Like, she can't even please. Hear. She doesn't even know.
Okay, one other weird thing,
Big
right?
Hands?
Now you know in downtown, right? There's this one alleyway going towards Franco's Pizzeria.
Yes.
So Franco's Pizzeria, great pizza place, by the way. Does the slices very cheap, by the way. Supreme
yo,
pizzas for
just,
super
like,
cheap.
A pizza
yo,
advertising
yo, Franco's
site
Pizzeria,
now?
Trash. The only thing they do good,
nah,
breakfast pizza. I stand by it.
So, fucking, I go over to this pizza place, right? I go to pee in between going to this pizza place and beer garden, and I'm in the alleyway, and you can hear Patty tell me to hurry up, and then tells Cass and Dakota that she's gonna go pee next to me. A little weird.
That's
Grown girl's about to take a piss next to my fucking
dick. Like, you're gonna go
dick.
See, you're
like,
gonna.
My
you're
man's
gonna,
dick is out here like this.
And your vagina.
A piss,
and you wanna
leave. Right? And she's like, let me just
jump
right next to him.
She really did, though?
She wanted no. to. She
I
wanted
was like,
to.
You're gonna take a piss next to my man's dick.
Like, nah.
And she was like, okay, no, I'll wait.
The tea
I was
is
like,
hot, y'all. The tea is scalding.
It's so hot, I burned myself.
Oof,
so like, I finish up, right? She immediately runs to the, where I peed. I'm like, wow, she's marking my territory. Taking over my territory that quick.
For real, she pissed on the same spot he pissed in.
And I'm just like, damn, girl. Like, dude, she was so sloshed. It wasn't even funny.
Oh, no.
I haven't seen, like, you know,
so, like.
Like
I, so, like, at first I was kind of, like, regretting that I didn't go out with you guys. Because, like, by the time. I didn't have to go check out that apartment because I got the call. I secured the one that I wanted.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, brother.
Hell yeah.
I'm still sort of salty with you both.
Why?
Y'all were like 2 blocks away from me.
Well, she was working till 8, 6 to 8.
Yeah, well,
and
like,
then I had to work. On
yeah,
the
I didn't even know
we were the
there,
last
we were
scorers
here.
On trivia night. We were the worst.
Well, you're not
what
at trivia night
trivia?
To get it right.
I know, like I was
it's
personally.
Like,
what was the trivia topic?
The topic of the night was 90s movies.
Okay, so before we get too far away from this, I'd like to say that this entire story was brought to you by Women in March.
Ha!
I think it's extremely humanizing to hear that not everyone is a good person.
Okay.
Or at least gets drunk and does like reprehensible things.
Wait, what about me?
On the name of that podcast.
On the name of that podcast, we like to talk about other people.
Can we name it Drunk and Reprehensible?
Drunk and Reprehensible?
In Women's History Month?
It's the Women's History Month episode.
Yeah, Drunk and Reprehensible in Women's History.
Nah, I like just the first part.
Hey, Alton, we have roaches.
Well.
Yo, Ty, we are on recording. You have to be more specific when you make these statements.
Oh, no, we totally
we
got roaches.
Resonated marijuana.
If you guys have ever seen Joe's apartment, if you've ever seen Joe's apartment,
I'm sorry,
we had those kinds of roaches.
I recommended you today.
To who?
Ashley.
Who's that?
She was my cheer coach. She was like my big sister when I was growing up. So she was like, hey, what podcast do you guys listen to? And I was just like, hey, yo, let me just fucking look up YouTube.
Listen,
and I look up YouTube,
clones.
Copy text, I paste it, and I was like, here you go.
Yeah,
hey, babe, this is where it's at.
Hey, babe, can you take a 90 degree? Yep, thank you.
I'm calling the police.
I
you
live here.
Guys!
It went cold, Tyler. It went cold.
You got the
no.
Huh?
I heard her still.
It was somewhere.
Oh, yeah. It really hurt.
Over the rainbow.
We have roaches.
So, Alton, I heard.
Oh, don't even trip, dog.
So, Alton, I heard that you found suddenly a new letter from
Are you
Civil
drinking
War.
This or are you drinking alcohol?
Me?
Yeah, I
or
heard, I heard that you have discovered
this
new letter.
I was kidding.
And I would love
I was
to
no,
read
I
it aloud
you
for
said before
you if you would mind at some point in the future.
No, what?
Yeah, no, for sure. I got that.
Yeah,
I got
so
tons
like,
of those. I actually got tons of those from the Civil War.
So, yeah, so I heard, like, you found, like, a whole, like, cache of them. Like, 100, like, a bunch of Civil War different, like letters.
It's insane.
Here, I got it.
No, we totally do have that, Eddie, don't we?
What?
Baby boy!
What'd you say?
I don't know.
Alton, are you hungry? Danny, are you hungry?
Oh, no, thank
I'm
you.
Not hungry.
I ate before I got here.
Alton, are you hungry? I'm not hungry for it. I was lying. I thought I would eat two, but I really... Oh, you know, I said
I got
a piece of pizza.
Not now.
Don't hit me.
Okay.
I have pizza
one. I'm a civilian. I thought I was going to eat two, but I really thought I was going to eat one, so I thought I was going to eat two.
Please get the pizza box away from our heads.
I just wanted to tell you what was happening.
Women's History Month.
Women's History Month. We're drunk, and we're ranting about them. But, like, anyway, so that's Civil War, right?
So, like,
so I heard that Women's History, right? Boom. On the Civil War. They were, like, working pretty hard, right? Like, they were doing their shit.
I'd say women were working the hardest during the Civil War.
I agree. Like, probably. Definitely that's facts right there.
Usually,
like,
when the men went to war, the women had to pick up the slack. And yeah. Then often kept the slack after the war.
Because, like, getting shot at is actually way easier than raising a family. And I... And I'm, so, like, I know... I know I'm an asshole, but I say that in earnest.
My pizza is the pizza slice spot.
Because I've been shot at.
Even though I said I have one, even though I thought I had
And Jim
two.
Varney?
What's that?
What, who's Jim Varney?
Jim Varney? You say it in earnest?
Oh, yeah. Ernest!
Yeah, I say it in Bert, too.
Oh, no. What?
Danny, we're divorced.
No.
You were never
divorced.
Man, I didn't even get to go to a wedding!
Married. You're happily married first.
Ernie.
For, like, 20 minutes.
Maybe you shouldn't eat cookies in the goddamn bed, Ernie.
She called me a bitch, and I didn't like that.
Hey, man. Hey, look. A woman calling another woman a bitch doesn't always hit 100%.
Oh, I have so what do you have? No, it
does not. No, it doesn't.
You have to gauge your audience.
So, Danny.
Yes, dear.
You want to tell a story about the most...
Oh, don't put me on the spot.
No. I don't know. I don't know what you're going to say. I'm just going to ask the question.
What?
It's up to you what you say, right? Yeah. Why don't you tell me a story about when you felt like you were going to be history as a woman? When were you going to die? You ever feel like you were just going to be like, that was my life right there?
I mean, like...
That's a much different question.
That's a different kind of women's history, huh? Yeah, history woman.
I got a few scenarios.
Give us your favorite one that you're willing to broadcast.
There was the one time my dumbass... I'm not friends with her anymore, but she was one of my best friends at the time.
Okay.
This bitch. We went to the corner store when she went to drop me off in a car. On the way... Blah, blah, blah. Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
So she went to drop me off. We went to go get some cigarettes. We were underage, so we couldn't go in the store and buy them. We tried to find someone to buy them. So I found someone to purchase some cigarettes. I went up and I was like, hey, someone, do me a favor real quick. And homie was like, yeah, okay, so come over here, give me the money. And I was like, all right, bet. Go over there, give him the money. He keeps it moving. He keeps walking towards my friend's car.
That was more.
I said, he says, is that your ride? And I said, no.
Baby.
He said, oh, are you sure? And I said, yeah, he keeps walking towards her, and I'm like, oh, fuck, here we go. He's like, are you sure that's not your ride? Yeah, dude, I ain't got no ride. I'm walking home. And so he keeps going over there. This dumbass bitch. This man was raggedy as a motherfucker, y'all. He was, like, 45, if I'm being fucking kind. And he was drunk and possibly on other things. I don't know. There was a smell.
He was on the edge of death because he was so old. He was 80.
But yeah,
it was Mitch McConnell.
He walks up.
I'm Mitch McConnell. Would you like a ride?
I'm gonna give you a ride.
Bro, homie walks towards the car, and she opens her window, and she's like, yeah, because she's dumb. And so he goes like, hey, can I get a ride? And I'm the entire time he's walking towards her, I'm screaming, Tracy, lock the car. Lock the fucking car. Lock the car, you dumb bitch. Lock the fucking car. And so he goes up, hey, can I get a ride? And she's like, yeah, hop in. She literally, like, looks at him in the face and goes, yeah, sure, hop in. Casual as fuck. She didn't act scared. Now, if that bitch was Sansa Stark, if she was actually scared. That's all I'm saying, that acting.
If you know, you know.
But yeah, so the bitch tells him to get in the car, and I'm like, Tracy, no, stop. Lock the, get the fuck to...
Lock the door. He's in the car.
No, before he opened the door, I'm like, no, lock the shit, bitch. And then so...
Don't throw him the keys.
I'm like, oh, fuck, here we go. No, I got another story about that. Hold on.
Well, it'll be your turn.
Don't sign over the deed of the car to him. Jesus.
Wait, stop. What are you taking your shoes off for?
So... He says, y'all want cigarettes? And she's like, yeah. And I'm like, oh, fuck, here we go.
He's trying to kill them both with cigarettes. I've seen this move about 6,000 times a year.
Here's my worst quality is I'm a ride or die to a stupid extent.
Mm-hmm.
Because I got in the car with her.
You're a ride or die, and you'll be red or dead. She's a ginger, guys.
Yes. But yeah, so
she likes R&B. That's how she gets her soul.
Ow. I don't have many problems.
That's how she gets her fix. So all gingers have to listen to R&B and soul music.
It's or like a just vampire drinking like animal blood instead of human. It's the same thing.
So the name of that podcast is also sponsored by Red AirPods.
Stop. But yeah, so this motherfucker gets in the car. She starts driving, and she goes, "Well, where do you need to go?" And he's like, "Well, if y'all want cigarettes, come on down here." She drives to fucking Lincourt.
Lincourt for cigarettes?
Yeah, from and where? I'm looking at her like, bitch, and she's looking at me like, bitch.
Wait, from where?
James Street.
What the fuck?
Next to the palace.
Drives them across town.
Yeah.
Well, she drives him across town in a car that I imagine she locked after he got in, because she drives... I like being in a car with locked doors.
Yeah, so the dumb bitch does this. And he goes, "Well, if y'all want cigarettes, drive down here, blah, blah, blah." And so we're in the car. This is when Spike was real, real popular.
Yeah.
And so he was like, "Y'all smoke Spike?" And we were like, "Nah."
Y'all smoke Spike?
Yeah, and you know, as soon as you hear the question, "Y'all smoke Spike," it's like, oh lord, here we go.
Yeah, that's the end of that social interaction.
No, it's not. If for some reason it's not, it's like, oh no. That's like that moment, the meme. But yeah. So she drives the Lincourt.
He's like...
Basket, question mark?
Yeah, right? Where's the basket? It says hit, but...
Oh yeah, Tyler, it's your thing, man. It's your hit. Hashtag Team Tyler.
Team Tyler, passed around.
The name of that podcast.
So we get to this place where he tells her to go, and he gets out of the car and goes, "Y'all want cigarettes? I'm about to get y'all some cigarettes." And goes to a closed gas station.
She's like, "Oh, he's like, oh yeah, baby, I got so many cigarettes."
He's like, "I'm gonna get you all the cigarettes you want," because and then goes to a closed gas station to do what I'm assuming is at least attempting to, if not succeeding in robbing. So I looked at her and I was like, "Bitch, peel." And she was like, drives me back to my house in Eastwood.
Wait, now, did she do that with the car or with her mouth before she drove away?
Probably both, because that bitch be screeching.
She was... Just imagine somebody
then
like,
he stumbled back outside. He's like, "I knew the owner. I have like 20 cartons. Where the hell did they go?"
Bone, down, digga, down, 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 down.
I've seen that episode music. Of Trailer Park Boys. Don't play me.
Nah, that's Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Yeah. What you said? I know the owner. But yeah, so yeah. Long story short, she drops me back.
How dare you say long story short? First of all,
hold on,
because you just made a long story and then you just try to cut
it
short.
It would have been a lot shorter.
You already told us all the details, Danny. Just finish the story.
I'm finishing the story, Tyler.
The name of that podcast is brought to you by Active Aggression. Get it out on the spot. We'll be cool later.
I love you too much.
I swear to God, Tyler.
I swear to God, I'll fucking smash your skull and then give you a hug.
Can't believe somebody peed
I'll
on
bottle
your pee.
You, mate. I swear to God, I'll fucking
someone
bottle
peed
you.
On my pee today.
Tyler got his peed on.
Someone marked my
that's
own.
That's a power move.
They took my territory somebody, and they fucking marked it.
Somebody marked his freshly marked territory.
Can't fucking believe it.
Like 30 seconds marked.
Like, yeah. Like
second coat.
Here's the thing. She waited. She was like, "Fine, I can't piss next to him. I'll piss on top of his piss." That'll teach everyone.
That's a power move.
It's a power move, man. I love it.
I hate it.
So, like, I don't love what happened, but I love power moves.
Okay, listen.
I don't love what happened. Let me be clear.
I hate all of it.
You like how all my displays are different colors?
Baby, where's my phone?
Just like a gamer.
Yeah, just like a gamer. No. Emphasis on the game.
It's almost June, y'all.
What's June? Gay History Month?
Well, I mean, Pride Month, but yeah.
Pride Month, Gay History Month.
Yeah.
I love it. Where's your History Month, Eddie? Which History Month do you identify with?
If you say yes, I'll look here for right now.
I mean,
none.
Yeah.
Ooh, non-binary History Month.
Not really.
Yeah. American History Month. So Christmas.
I guess.
Seriously?
Oh. Yep.
Christmas.
All of Christmas.
Yeah. The holiday season, really, from the end of October to the end of the year.
And the 2 months before that. Yep.
In the 2 months before that. Yeah, that's not bad. That's not a bad deal. I guess, like, you get from, like, July 4th to the end of the year, because every month has a pretty dope holiday. So you got July 4th, obviously. August has my birthday. September, got 9/11. October, you get Halloween. November, you get Thanksgiving. And,
you're so dumb.
Veterans Day.
That was to look
November's my birthday, bitch.
Not to answer my call.
November's Danny's birthday.
Most important.
I was talking about all the holidays. Clearly, we weren't making it about specific birthdays.
Watch, right? Yeah, I know.
It is. It's in the most important holidays. I just forgot where.
And
I
then Christmas.
It's probably
followed by Boxing Day, which is you like technically a holiday that like.
Wasn't that for servants?
It's for servants.
To have Christmas.
Because they have to work Christmas. Christmas is a huge holiday. But then they get the next day off to be with their family. They get like a box they get to split with their family.
Boxing Day, y'all.
You compromise.
I thought it was named after the Boxer Rebellion.
It's like,
ass.
I'm going to work you to the bone on Christmas. I'm going to make you watch the Christmas you can't afford.
Okay, get off my desk.
But tomorrow.
When you crawl in the box, we're going to wrap it.
Yeah. And you get to come out of the box in front of your family with all of our leftovers.
Speaking of women's history,
we're talking
about Buffy.
Buffy the Vampire Slayer?
Yeah.
So Danny wants to talk about Buffy the Vampire Slayer on Women's History Month.
Dryer, right?
It was Women's History.
Yeah.
It's Women's History. Sarah Michelle Gellar is an important part of Women's History now.
No, first lesbian kiss on TV.
First lesbian kiss on TV.
And then one of the lesbians was shot immediately after.
Whoa.
Literally, like, a second after.
So, like, were they explicitly gay, or were they, like, roommates?
No, they were, like, no, they were dating girlfriends. They had just not kissed.
So it wasn't like Sailor Moon and they were cousins?
No. And first of all, that was only America.
I know. Americans are weird. They're like, we'd rather the lesbos be cousins.
And
I'm like, both of those things are bad. The fact that you said lesbo.
They left the gay shit in there, so they were just gay cousins.
They were just gay cousins.
That sounds like make it joke. Better. Like, that or like
some,
what?
That sounds like some the heart shit.
America's like,
shit.
Yeah, there it is. That's palatable for our audience.
I know some gay cousins like that.
Is it better if they're related?
Yeah, no. It's like, there we go. Now people will think it's weird.
Alabama was cool with it.
Alabama's cool with more than they think.
Oh?
Yeah.
I like that statement. He knows Alabama better than Alabama, y'all.
Yeah, Alabama's bi-curious, but they're aggressive about it.
If they could take a pill to not be gay, they
would. I'm gay. Curious. I just choose to be.
Nah, Alabama's not gay. They'll just commit a hate crime to, like, wash away their gayness.
Like, which, the dudes from It?
I sucked a dude's dick. Now I'm gonna kill three gay dudes.
Oh my gosh. He's like equivalent exchange. It's like Full Metal Alchemist.
Since I got off, they gotta get off.
It's terrible. What a hot take.
Tyler, what the fuck?
Danny, if you haven't noticed yet, I have no chill when I've been drinking.
I know.
Altered, I didn't mean to offend you last night.
What the fuck did he say?
Uh-oh.
Oh, Tyler was just voicing frustrations that he has with our band practices.
Oh, okay,
It wasn't nothing to target him or anything like that, but I realized that I came off a little too strong, and I said some things that I didn't
mean
to say.
But honestly, in response to that, to be fair, I had some time to think about it since then, and I do dick off sometimes, so... You're fine.
It's mostly like when Michael goes off and does Megadeth and you just like follow him along. I have not only is enough, it's not contributing to the band, it's just like.
Yeah, and I feel like it might even encourage him.
But it discourages me and Joe. Me and Joe, we look at each other like, we're waiting to like continue on the song, like,
women's
we're just practicing
month.
On.
That's like
y'all
that white guy on
around.
Tinder wearing the dashiki and Black History Month.
Bro, there was a brother on Tinder. So, like, now I get to see the female side of Tinder now that Danny's trying it out every now and then. And she uses it like a normal person. You play the game show, you get bored with the game show, and then you delete the game show app.
They both on Tinder, they got a perfect match right next to each other.
What?
Wow.
What? What'd
you say?
No, I didn't say anything, man.
Rewind the tape. Rewind the fucking tape.
We got the receipts. But,
I'm just saying, man.
But yeah, so now I get to see what females see on Tinder, and boy howdy, let me tell you, it's exactly as bad as I thought.
It's not promising, y'all.
It's really bad. I don't know if it's just Syracuse. So when I was down in Virginia, I was on Tinder, and I saw the wildest, by far, hands down. The wildest thing I've ever seen on Tinder.
What's up?
And let me first say, I'll say one thing in preface. It was not inherently wrong.
Okay. Inherently.
It was just off the wall.
Yeah, it wasn't wrong, like, objectionably. It was just like, alright, it's just crazy. Anyway, so I'm on Tinder. I see this 21-year-old female, third trimester pregnant. Like, very, very, very pregnant, ready to go. And, like, half of her pictures were her pregnant.
You might be there for the birth.
I'm like, I'm in Virginia for 4 days.
Yeah, maybe. But like, if you meet up.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah, I might actually see this baby be born if we hit it off real quick.
Well, know. She's just worried about having a ride.
It's like that
episode. Yeah, maybe she just needs a ride. She's like, needs someone with an Uber.
It's like that episode of Misfits. You're going to end up adopting it, naming it Alton.
I don't know if I'll adopt a Virginia baby.
Nathan thought that about his.
Nathan doesn't have any Virginia babies.
No, but he has
West Virginia! You've
triggered him. You've prompted.
Take me home.
You are home!
Country road. You are
home. The name of that podcast brought to you by copyrighted content.
You're gonna get demonetized, Tyler.
Yeah, it's cool. We have one video that's not demonetized in America, but it's restricted in Japan. They can't see it. They're not allowed to watch
it. Yep. Thanks to me.
Which one is it?
It's episode 4.
Oh, I think I listened to that one.
That whichever episode uses like Gurenge as the end credit song. Whenever we started doing that,
I have not heard one end credit song. So for some reason, you know, I listened to the podcast on YouTube, right?
Yeah.
And I feel disrespected.
And so I listened to the podcast on YouTube, right? So, for some reason, I have YouTube Red, so I should be able to close everything and still be able to listen to it. Not your podcast. It stops playing every time.
On YouTube?
Yeah, I don't know why.
Hmm. I don't know.
I feel offended.
You should. Maybe because our podcast doesn't make any money, so it doesn't get the same features.
No, it does! Like, everything should have the same features. Literally. I'm paying for it, motherfucker.
Oh, you're paying for it. Yeah, it just transcends us. It's not our problem. Take that up with them. Take that up with YouTube customer service. It's got shit to do with the name of that podcast.
I was just saying.
Tarnishing our brand.
You trademark it yet?
You just want us to look bad. You're from the last podcast on the left, aren't you? Wait a minute. This bitch is from Harmontown.
What?
I recognize her. It's Eric McGaffey.
God damn it, Tyler. You gotta hum it. If you... Okay. The fuck is
there
that?
There you go.
He's triggering stuff. Me. He's triggering me, y'all. He's activating my fight or flight.
You should. It makes sense. Alright guys, you've been listening to the name of that podcast. This has actually been a commercial free episode. Our sponsors, I told them to take the night off. I told them I'd plug them.
Yeah.
And I told them that, you know, you'd get the content that you needed. Dedicated listeners. It's been a great episode. Having fun, having Danny on, Tyler and Cass, coming in the house drunk with buckets of hot water to spill all over the microphone.
Oh, God, it was so
And funny. Don't forget, if you love hot dogs, if you like Frankfurters, don't forget to go down to Jim's Frankfurter Taco Shop. He makes the best hot dog tacos that you'll ever have in your life. Enchiladas as well. Again, remember, it's Jim's Frankfurter Enchilada Shop downtown. You're welcome.
Hey, thanks so much, Tyler.
The one sponsor.
Hey, Cass, you want to sign us off?
It's that hot water with Cass and Ty. We'll be back to you soon next week.
We about to spill that tea, y'all.
We about to spill that tea.
All the tea. All right, guys, have a good night. Eddie, thanks for being on, man. You have fun in prison.
Oh, yeah. See ya.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Hi, we're Felicia's nieces.
Hi.
I'm Denise.
And I'm Aretha. Did you miss us?
Did you miss us? I bet you did, and now we have something to tell you.
Oh, yes, love. We do.
We're selling excursions now.
Hey, excursions.
You love vacations, don't you, sweetie?
Do you like taking trips?
You like going to different places?
I do.
I love going to different places. Here, come to us. We'll send you to amazing places, like the historic Kwanzaa Abbey.
Oh, my God.
I love that place. So many different colors.
And who could forget the rustic Christmas Islands?
I love Christmas Island.
Oh, they're beautiful.
Did you know Christopher Columbus made Christmas Island?
He did.
He did.
What a sweetheart.
And before you go to rustic Christmas Island, make sure you stop at the quaint Hanukkah Grove.
Oh, I love it. It's so good. They've got great food there.
That's right. When you're there, you have to say Hanukkah Grove.
I can't pass over that deal.
You know, Aunt Felicia, she told me about this place called the Ostrich Islands.
She did.
Next door to the Canary Islands.
Oh.
Yes, that bitch didn't call me till she got back, though.
And she didn't go through us. But we'll send you there.
We'll go to the Mid-Easter.
I'd love a Mid-Easter.
Yes.
I hardly know her. My Aunt Felicia, that is. She's dead to me. She's dead to me. That Guma is garbage.
All right.
She's never done anything good for us, Denise. Or am I Denise?
Felicia.
Felicia's never done anything good for us.
She gave us this commercial spot.
Ever since our mother Alicia died, Felicia hasn't said a word to us. Bye, an excursion. Love ya.
Bye.
Don't get shot at school, kids. It's really not that fun. And don't do it. Don't get shot at school.
You usually end up dead anyway, right?
You don't want to die at school, kids. So get ready. This fall, we got exactly what you need to make sure that you can get home from school, live to see another day, and get ready for tech class tomorrow.
Three pumped up kicks.
Three pumped up kicks are 50% more pumped than the leading brands, and they're sure to give you the edge. Get rootin' when the guns get shootin' with pre-pumped up kicks. Pre-pumped up kicks come in lots of different colors and sizes.
Get them, because they're going fast.
Going fast, and you'll be going even faster with pre-pumped up kicks on your feet. Be sure to strap on a pair of these, so when the strap comes out, only a pair of you'll get going. That's all you'll need, a pair, that is, of pre-pumped up kicks to get on the road and get the hell out of Dodge.
I want to run and run faster to these savings.
They also come in clear for Metal Detector Day. Pre-pumped up kicks.
William Shakespeare was a legendary playwright who has shaped the English language as we know it today. Come with us on a journey as we find one of his greatest monologues ever composed, reimagined, found stuck to the underside of his bedpost. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Romeo and Juliet. But superfluous, what light through yonder doctor's office breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the giraffe. Arise, fair sun, and sneeze the envious moon, who is already sick and rotund with grief, that thou her Joe Biden art far more fair than she. Be not her Joe Biden, since she is envious. Her vestal livery is but sick and green, and none but fools do cough it. Cast it off. It is my lady. Oh, it is my dry shampoo. Oh, that she knew she were. She poops, yet she says nothing. What of that? Her penis's discourses, I will answer it. I am too consecrated. Tis not to me she poops. Two of the fairest stars in all of the Washington Square, having some business, do entreat her penises to talk in their rhombuses till they return. What if her penises were there, they in her head? The knee of her cheek would shame those stars as daylight doth a lamp. Her penises in Washington Square would through the airy turtle stream so bright that ninja turtles would scream and think it were not night. See how she leans her cheek upon her door. Oh, that I were a glove upon that door, that I might touch that cheek.
Family Watchdog is what you're gonna need. It's the same setup every fucking time.
We could just start with the noise.
Alright.
And then at the end, when the police show up and stuff, you just say,
FamilyWatchdog.us. Because you need to feel safe. Alright, so what we'll do is we'll say something like, your families are always at risk of being molested. And then we'll let the sound effects kick in like this.
Do you know if danger is right around the corner?
Right, and then the police sirens. FamilyWatchdog.us has got your back. Your heart's beating, and children are getting molested.
Pedophiles are skeeting.
Oh, shit. Shoot them.
Bang, bang.
FamilyWatchdog.us. Get your family.
What color pants?
Blue?
Yeah, I was thinking blue.
Alright.
Not purple? Blue?
Nah, blue.
Okay.
I feel like it's the best time to voice my displeasure. I'm so fucking mad right now. It's been like 3 fucking times this entire podcast and I forgot to turn the fucking microphone on. Thank you for being a tryhard.
It's because you're mad about Columbus.
I'm so mad about Columbus.
It's fucking up the recordings.
Yeah. I hope I like more editing. Folks don't think we're trying hard now.
We're not!
Fuck this, man. I'll stop any day now. I'm only doing this so I don't go into a depressive state. Oh, hold up. Now you're obligated to my content. Wow. Thanks, fans. Yeah. Yeah, I'll put out there. I'll lay it out. I'll speak plainly. I'm depressed. And I do this to focus on my hobbies outside of work because work used to keep me happy and now it can't.
Help!
Please! This podcast is more than a passion project. It's a cry for help.
It's an SOS flare.
That's what you want from me, right? You want me to tell you when I'm not feeling so good so you can talk it out with me. Well, here we are. Talking it out in the end credits.
The jolly music.
Yep, doesn't this feel good? This is a Christopher Columbus episode. Remember the racist, genocidal maniac who went on a quest for gold? Yeah. He's literally a fucking pirate. And, I need to talk to somebody about it. Well, my problem is anyway, because we did a lot of Christopher Columbus today.
Not enough people knew, though.
You know, Christopher Columbus is pretty much Trump.
He's close.
Yeah.
Trumpless.
The earth is only 3,000 miles away, Eddie.
What a life.
What a life.
It happened on one of them zippity-doo-dah days. Now there's to come a day when you can't open your mouth.